Let's talk about the rappers. I done seen when y'all done had back and forth with rappers, and they was like, you know, calling y'all snitches and dry snitching and saying that y'all need to get beat up. You know what I'm saying? And things like that. Me personally, rappers put theyself on the internet, put their crimes on the internet, or record it, or however it got on the internet, it's already there. Once it hit the internet, it's worldwide news now. It take 5 minutes on the internet for information to travel from Texas to probably China. This shit hit the world that fast through social media. You know what I'm saying? So how do y'all feel about rappers snitching on themselves and then blaming on y'all or get mad at y'all for, nigga, I'm going to post all my guns and post all this money and then stay down seeing that they posted, oh, man, y'all snitching, like, or a fight or anything. You know what I'm saying?
Huh? You got it from your page.
So, yeah.
We only got it. That's the only way we can repost if you put it up. You put it up and we just post them what you put up. That's our job.
Yeah.
But, you know, people DM and ask you to take it down.
Yeah.
But, you know, we really can't do that because that's what we here for, though, to have the information up there.
Understand, once it's out there, it's out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, taking it down, you might keep a few people from seeing it, but somebody in the screen recorded it. Whenever you go live in your trap with your gas bags and your Dracos and this and that, and especially if you are a rapper that's known with a following, somebody's screen recording it.
Yeah.
They might not tell you, they're not going to tell you they screen recording it. You know what I'm saying? But they screen recording that shit. They watching your every move if you got a name. Yeah. That's just what it is, man. So you can't blame State Eye. You can't blame Say Cheese. You can't blame Vlad. If you put it out there on the internet, then, hey, now somebody snuck some footage of you. Snuck it. It's still not y'all fault. You know what I'm saying? Hey, man, they snuck that footage of me. It didn't come from me. If they hit y'all and ask y'all then to take it down, would y'all kind of be more understanding if you feel like they telling the truth?
Yeah, it'd have been cases like somebody like Jay the Youngin.
Yeah.
Like, he a convicted felon, right?
Yeah.
He did a video with Scotty Kane. Yeah. Scotty Kane posted the video. The rapper that he was with,
yeah,
they posted the video. They was in, like, the woods shooting guns.
Yeah.
Scotty Kane, the rapper that Jay the Youngin was with, shot the guns with, he posted the video.
Gotcha.
We reposted the video from Scotty Kane.
Okay.
He DM'd us. Remind you, the video is still on Scotty Kane page.
Yeah.
Oh, can y'all take this down? I'm a convicted felon. Y'all trying to send me to jail.
Yeah.
Remind you, the video is still on Scotty Kane page.
Yeah.
But he wanted us. We did delete it because he said he was a convicted felon or whatever. We don't want that to be the case. But again, the video was still on a rapper that he was with page. And it's just stuff like that. And I want to kind of go back to the original question you asked. Like, people, I think Killer Carleone was the one that said that, if I'm not mistaken. But I just want to say this. We're not a gangsters. Well, I don't never claim to be a gangster, never try to be a gangster, but blogging is not what we wanted to do our whole life. It's just something we pick up. Now, if someone feel like, oh, people should come beat us up, that's what y'all want to do. Like, I'm not saying y'all will beat us up. Y'all might get beat up, but that's what y'all want to do, then y'all should do that. But I don't feel like we post anything that will make people, oh, fuck, stay down. But that's what people do. But, hey, never tried to be a gangster or anything like that. But I don't think we no hoes neither. So if that's what y'all want to do, then, hey, so be it. But I don't feel like we control page. Sometimes it be so much stuff that goes on, we can post it. But we don't even post, like, because it's like, nah, I don't even do that. It's going to be too much and stuff like that.
Right.
And it's what we do not create content. We only post what we are given, like, what do we see. We post stuff. We don't, oh, damn, let's go tomorrow and we're going to record this fight.
Yeah.
That's original content. We just post what people put out.
Yeah, what they put out on their pages, what they put out on their stories, their lives, or whatever they see. Yeah, on the internet. I get it. And that's a big thing going on right now, like with DJ Academics, you know what I'm saying? Like, the whole, it seems like all these rappers is banding up against them. And I fuck with these rappers. I want to be clear. Fuck with Meek Mill heavy. Nigga would love to interview Meek Mill. Nigga fuck with Freddie Gibbs. I was going to Freddie Gibbs shows out here back in the day. But to see these niggas going in, trying like this, focus on Academics. And understand, bro, niggas can't cancel Stay Down. Niggas can't cancel Academics because you already said you're not a gangster, you're not acting out of your character, and you don't need them to keep your shit going. Academics don't need nobody. Like, that's what niggas don't understand. That nigga was doing this shit in his house. If y'all don't want to, y'all don't have to leave y'all crib. And guess what? Niggas is still gonna go to Stay Down Productions Instagram because of the simple fact y'all got the content and they know what y'all on already. People want the drama. People want the controversy. People want the mess. That's what sells. It sucks that it's like that, but it is what it is.
And we're not even, I don't think we post like that. Man. I don't think we post like messy.
Yeah. Y'all do, but it's like, it ain't no different from nobody else. It ain't nothing different from what nobody else is doing. You're not going
to see like no drama every day on
TV. No. Y'all ain't every day. Yeah. Y'all not all day.
Like, it might, like not going to say his name. He DM'd us.
Yeah.
Not going to say his name. He just swiped up on one video and he was like, oh, because I was like, people in Atlanta, like the way Atlanta set is work, like they rappers, like, you know, you think people always say Houston should be like Atlanta.
Yeah.
You think people in Atlanta not getting into it with each other every day,
they
but it's like they just try their best to not let it leave Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it didn't even get to the point where people in Atlanta would pay big time bloggers not to post certain stuff. So rappers slid up and he was like, oh, so we should pay y'all. He was just joking.
Yeah.
But I was like, honestly, like, we don't even post mess unless it's something like, oh, damn. Oh, y'all, we just got to post it. It's obvious. Like, we got to post it. Like, why wouldn't we post it? Like,
Rizzo and Max so
funny. Yeah, like, there's just something, like, we had to post it because it's like, first of all, it happened in Houston. And then it wasn't nothing. Nobody died. They was able to shake hands. Like, why wouldn't we post it?
I feel like that.
Most people should do that. Like, it don't have to result to violence or somebody dying or somebody pulling out a gun. Just fight and get it over with. Shake hands and go home.
Facts. That's how they work, man. I just know, like, being in y'all position, even with me not even posting to my Instagram about the stuff, you know, I cover things in commentary, but it'd be more mainstream stuff. Or I cover Houston stuff too. I cover a lot of Sauce and TSF stuff on the story whenever Sauce get into it with somebody. I cover it, but I do my best to not make a nigga feel a certain type of way. I just speak the facts and give my honest opinion. And niggas is just gonna find a way because you in the position, and that really shows me your value. Like, to me, that's my value because you care that much about what I got to say.
Not true.
Right now, they've shown, when niggas get mad at you, they show you that you're valuable.
Not true.
Same thing with academics.
I want to add this though. Yeah. People will say we messy. Oh, y'all post NBA Youngboy, but I never seen a rapper say, oh, Shire Stay Down Productions for the Cash App giveaways. They bought people food today for people that couldn't afford a meal. I never seen people say, oh, thank y'all for doing what y'all doing. Oh, thank y'all for giving us studio time to record. Oh, thank y'all, because we want our whole life to get on Say Cheese, but we didn't have the money to afford it. Thank y'all for putting us on Say Cheese. I never heard not one rapper say thank you.
Yeah.
Say, oh, nah, they doing this. Oh, I never heard not one rapper coming down. Say, dang, like, all this stuff going on in the city, they bringing these people together. They got these people working together. Yeah. These people will probably never make a song together once they leave the studio. But look what State Out Productions did. I never seen nobody mention the positive things that we did. We might post somebody, it was an example, like something that just happened. Somebody had drawn, but it was another video. Somebody had saved somebody for drowning, and we just received so much slack behind it. It was a positive video. Somebody, a kid jumped in the pool, was about to lose his life. His dad was able to save
the white kid.
Yeah,
I seen that. Was jumped over the thing. Yeah,
and we just got backlash from it. Why would y'all post that? If something just happened, somebody just lost their life. Life, like, not in a negative way, but life goes on. Not saying that's bad, but I'm just saying, like, negative things happen and positive things happen. Like, there was a negative situation, but we posted about the positive situation. This is something positive. Whenever we post positive things, it always get overlooked. People don't care about the positive.
Hell no.
They only want to see the negative. That's all they want to see. They get the most attention.
Now, y'all don't write the stories in the order they go in, shit. That video went viral of him catching that baby. If y'all chose to post it, that's y'all platform. You know what I'm saying? It ain't y'all fault that happened to somebody else. You know what I'm saying? Just, you know, condolences to them. But it wasn't no disrespect to. But I know how people be moving, man. They be moving petty. People looking to point the finger because they not happy in their situations. It is what it is. But nah, niggas is so focused on trying to get the person with the content creator out of it. And that shit is crazy to me. y'all showing how important the nigga is when y'all trying to get rid of it. Niggas to go get on their Twitter and go at niggas and da da. It's like, damn, I feel I don't agree with every, like, I can look at State Isle and I can say, hey, I probably wouldn't have posted that. You feel me? That's my personal opinion. That's no knock on you. That's no knock on you. It might be a lot of shit that say, okay, that ain't me. But guess what? I'm not ever gonna say they don't deserve this position because y'all do this shit every day. Y'all taking time out y'all day. Y'all risking y'all everything. Y'all putting y'all money behind it. This y'all platform is popping for a reason. You know what I'm saying? So I can't tell y'all how to move on y'all shit. I can have my opinions and critique. Well, I would have did this a little bit better or that a little bit better, whatever. But it's never personal, and I'm never mad. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I feel like that's what the internet for.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You're gonna give out your opinion, yeah. But you will never hear me say some niggas that's working don't deserve this spot. Like, I'm never finna be a State Island Production don't deserve that. You know what I'm saying? These niggas be acting like y'all don't deserve y'all shit, and y'all done been up all night, all hours of the night. All day outside. I'd have been to the video shoot with you when it's hot than a motherfucker out there. You know what I'm saying? And y'all go through it just like the rest of the niggas. This shit is just as hard as being a rapper. All day niggas, if not harder.
People harder. Don't understand
that. Yeah, they don't
get it. It's just like how people say it's dangerous to be a rapper. It's dangerous to be bloggers.
For shit,
people,
so.
they never love to admit the positive things that we've done. Come February, we're gonna have our 3rd year anniversary. I'm not sure if you ever seen it. It be packed out. It's free. We never charge people a dollar. It's free to get in. It's free to perform. You performing in front of at least 300 people at least, and that's it be packed out, full of people. Never made a dollar from any showcase we had.
Yeah.
But people know they don't like to bring them things up. But I know you probably was speaking in general. But I want to ask though, you ever, like, what post would you say, oh, y'all posted, I wouldn't have posted that?
I can't really just remember off the top, but I know how it works though. I don't trip. I just say that's just not my style. Where, like, you have to do it though. You have to put that caption out there to make the followers interact. And you know it's some messy shit up above in the video. But you gotta type the caption a little to make the niggas feel like it's some bullshit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's a part of it. I get it. You know what I'm saying? I just wouldn't do it for what I do. You see what I'm saying? But for what y'all do, that's how you get the interactions up. That's business. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, y'all didn't make the content. Y'all just posted it. You know what I'm saying? I don't like to see niggas take L's. I don't.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's just me. I don't like to see niggas getting humiliated. I don't like to see niggas get beat. I don't like to see niggas get caught cheating. I'm like, damn, bro. I wish that nigga could have did that in private. You know what I'm saying? That's why I don't post it. And when I have my little blog page, I'm not going to be running it. You know what I'm saying? I'll cover the shit that I want to cover on the YouTube channel or the talk show, but I don't want to be the nigga actually that is sending it to the people without putting my narrative on it, because that's the disadvantage y'all are at as bloggers, to where y'all just look like harsh animals or demons or fucked up ass people, because y'all don't get to talk with it. When you go to Instagram is quick, so they don't really get to see how y'all really feel. Even if you typed it out, which it ain't enough time for that, they're not gonna read it anyways, but they can't see how y'all really feel about it. You see what I'm saying? And that's why I say, like, okay, this might be a post with, because I can't see how you feel about this shit. You see what I'm saying? But nah, I fuck with it all, man. Like, it's entertaining. Y'all got an entertaining platform. Y'all find entertaining content that ain't got nothing to do with, like, just funny shit, funny tweets.
That's what we try to do. Like, you know, just give people, because certain people follow us for certain different reasons. Yeah. So we just try to, like, you know, satisfy everybody. Some people don't care about who the next upcoming rapper. Some people want to see, like, we might say, oh, Anchors, if this such and such top 35 baddest female in the world. Some people love to see that.
Yeah.
Some people love to see, like, just funny videos that don't have nothing to do with nothing.
Yeah.
Sports.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, now, y'all cover everything for shit show. It ain't no denying that, man. So.